Good afternoon and welcome to today's ceremony in recognition of the promotion of Major Lionel Taylor to the rank of Lieutenant Colonel, and a warm welcome to our distinguished guest, Colonel Lewis D. Gray. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the arrival of the official party and remain standing for the playing of our national anthem and the invocation given by Elder Russell Frazier Sr. from Cornerstone True Fellowship. During the playing of the national anthem, we ask that all military personnel stand at attention and civilian personnel place their right hand over their heart. Today's ceremony and extend a warm welcome to all of you. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce today's special guest, Colonel Lewis D. Gray of the United States Army Recovery Care Program, United States Army Medical Command.
So today is a great day for the Taylor friends and family, for the Army Finance Corps, and also for the United States Army. I'm honored to be here. I saw the promotion list, and I was thinking I was going to give Lionel a text or something and just say, hey, congratulations, I see you on the list. But next thing you know, he said, hey, sir, I want you to come down and promote me. And without a doubt, without hesitation, I said, I'd love to. I would love to be there. Because these things are important. You know, it's important to have these ceremonies. For the honoree, you know, you do so much work, you need to be recognized. You need somebody to say, hey, you're doing great. Keep going. Keep going. And you also inspire others that are sitting there watching you. But you also do these ceremonies for your friends and your family, the people that support you, the people that got you where you are. You know, they want to see you succeed. And it also gives you the opportunity to thank them for what they've done for you, because the Army is a team sport. And not one person in the Army can do it on their own. So, you know, I know there have been a lot of people helping you. You helped me. So, you know, you got to pay it forward and have ceremonies like this to recognize each other. I learned it the hard way. I graduated from Mississippi State. I couldn't afford FAMU. you know, I just thought, okay, I finished everything. I just skipped the whole ceremony. And my mom was reading the paper, and back then they read the paper. And she said, she saw the listing of all the other ceremonies, and she said, when's yours? And I said, I already got my degree. And she said something that stuck with me to this day. She said, it's not just about you. So I learned that lesson. The Army got it right this time. I mean, sometimes, you know, promotions are based on potential. Sometimes they get it wrong. But there's no doubt in my mind that they got it right this time. I met Lionel back in 2004 at Fort Campbell, Kentucky. I was the company commander, and he was my executive officer. And I knew then that this is somebody that would excel in the Army. You know, the Army always talks about being tactically and technically proficient. But what they don't really teach you, and he can't teach it, is you gotta care about people. And if you don't care about people, you won't be successful. So, this promotion now, you know, he's moving from major to lieutenant colonel. And it's a position where you move from being an action officer to a strategic thinker. So lieutenant colonels, you know, the Army promotes lieutenant colonels to lead battalions. And most people in here probably not in the military, but a battalion could be anywhere from 300 to 1,000 people. Just imagine being the person in charge that they call the old man that, you know, gives all the orders. So, you know, that is the rank that he is at, where the Army could potentially say, hey, I want you to go lead a battalion. So this is a very important step. The rank structure in the Army, it's like a pyramid, and it gets tighter at the top. So when you're a lieutenant, and you go into your second lieutenant, you go to first lieutenant, everybody's gonna get promoted if you don't kill anybody or get a DUI. It's like 99.9% promotion rate. But then you get to captain, and they start to shave some off. Then you get to major, and now we down to maybe only 70% gonna make it. Then you get to lieutenant colonel, with 60%. Then colonel, then general. I mean, it gets tighter, it's really tight. And then he's in the finance corps, where it's even tighter. So you just really don't know, you can't really understand, if you're not in it, how important this promotion is for somebody to get promoted to lieutenant colonel in the finance corps. So I'm super proud. So that's all I have. I want to say again, thank you for having me. I wouldn't have missed it for the world. When you said, hey, sir, could you come down? I looked at my wife and I said, I'm going to Florida. And, you know, she looked at me funny, and I told her why. And she said, oh, okay. Because she knows Lionel too. We all serve together. And she knows that you have to take care of people. You have to take care of people that took care of you. So without a doubt, this was no hesitation. So thank you for having me. I'm honored to be here. Thank you.
This is, thank you everybody. This is very important to me, and we kind of passed the, did a little different for the protocol, but I would like Uncle Russell, Elder Frazier, could you please give the invocation that we spoke about over today's ceremony, please, sir?
Okay. Good evening, folks.
Good evening.
How y'all doing?
Beautiful.
Are you blessed?
Yes.
Are you blessed?
Yes.
Are you blessed?
Yes.
Are there are many not blessed this morning and this afternoon. And we just thank God that he's watching over us here. And he's protecting us. I just want to thank you because we are going through this pandemic. Right now, there are many families out there lost a loved one, but God have blessed us that we can come together. That he had put his hand, his covering over this family.
Yes, yes, sir.
I thank God for how he have protected us. through it all. And as we go through, let us not forget who brought us here.
Yes.
Let us not forget who we should give all praises and honor to. Give it to the Lord. Because
yes.
Without him, we can do nothing.
Amen.
We don't even exist without him. And my prayer is today, now as God promotes you, and your young son see you being promoted, also God is elevating you to another level also.
Yes.
Not just here on earth, but he giving you another elevation in heaven. That your responsibility have become more than what you can even dream or think. And I said to you this day, that God is going to watch over you and your boys, because there's a covering over you. And over this family, God, I pray that God will watch over each and every one of you,
thank you,
with this covering. A covering of protection, because we know that you have to be wise and smart during this time. And let us not let our guards down. Let's stay vigilant while we are out here. And Lord, I just thank you now that you will watch over this family, Lord, day and night. God, protect them, Father God, protect them from this sickness. Lord, let it cover them. In your son Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
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 Please take center stage. Okay. Attention to orders. The President of the United States has reposed special trust and confidence in the patriotism, valor, fidelity, and abilities of Lionel Anthony Taylor. In view of these qualities and his demonstrated potential for increased responsibility, he is therefore promoted to the rank of Lieutenant Colonel, effective November the 1st, 2000. Thank you. At this time, Colonel Gray will administer. Charles Sr., Lionel Jr., Christopher and Nathan Nathaniel move forward to with new shoulder boards cover rank. Charles Sr., Lionel Jr., Christopher and Nathaniel will exchange epithet and shoulder board. Nathaniel will exchange old rank and new rank on the beret. Colonel Gray, Lieutenant Colonel Taylor, and family will take pictures later. Okay. At this time, Colonel Gray will administer the oath of office with Lieutenant Colonel Taylor.
Raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, state your name.
I, Lionel Anthony Taylor.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
Support and defend.
To support and defend.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
Against all enemies.
Against all enemies.
Foreign and domestic.
Foreign and domestic.
That I will bear true faith.
That I will bear true faith.
And allegiance to the same.
And allegiance to the same.
And that I take this obligation freely.
That I take this obligation freely.
Without any mental reservation.
Without any mental reservation.
Or purpose of evasion.
Or purpose of evasion.
And that I will well.
And that I will well.
And faithfully discharge.
And faithfully discharge.
The duties of the office.
The duties of the office.
Upon which I'm about to enter.
Upon which I'm about to enter.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Lieutenant Colonel Taylor.
First, give an honor to God, who's ahead of my life. I thank the Lord for leading and keeping me protected through my Army career and my life. To all my family, my aunts, uncles, cousins, nephew, nieces, to my friends in attendance, my virtual guests, I'm truly grateful you can join us today to share in this celebration. Colonel Gray, thank you for hosting today's ceremony. You're my first company commander, as you stated, at Fort Campbell, Kentucky, back in 2004. You set an example in many ways that I followed through my career of how an African-American commissioned officer should lead, be a father, and a friend. I thank you for your mentorship and your support through the years.
Charles, if I ever would. It's okay. It's okay. God is good. It's okay.
Words cannot express the gratitude that I have for you.
Yes, sir.
And the unconditional love and foundation.
Thank you, Lord.
A family, the foundation of family that you established in my life.
Thank you, Father God. Thank you for life. Thank you.
Because of you both and the life lessons you've taught me, I've always been a better son, brother, father, man. Mom's not here in presence and body, but she's here in spirit.
She's here. Who we spoke with last night, huh?
And she's grateful.
I know it.
Jesus. I just want to thank you for your love and sacrifice and support to our family. We've been through so much. And I want to present to you a small token that reflects my thankfulness.
Thank you.
He is a good God.
And you know, Diana Williams. If you know Diana Williams. So, you know, I can't give my father a gift without giving her a gift.
Mom's a killer, since you know that.
This is her gift.
You don't know mom's a killer.
Right, this is her gift. So all the ladies here, she loves the, she loves lavender. That was her favorite color.
Lavender, yes sir.
Lavender. So I want my boys to give every lady in here a gift bag. And it's a bracelet. I'm going to get every lady, please, a gift bag. And it's a bracelet that I hope you
thank
wear
you
with love and gratitude. Every lady. In remembrance of her. To my sons, Lionel Jr., Christopher, and Nathaniel, I'm truly blessed to be your father. Being a father is the most important job I have. I'm rewarded daily through all of you here. And just the memory we share. You all make me so proud. And I'm gonna give you a gift.
Oh.
If you know I'm stationed at Fort Knox, Kentucky, right? It's the home of the Fort Knox bullion, where they keep all the gold at. So I was able to knock on some doors, rub some elbows, and get some uncirculated $2 bills.
Oh, wow.
That were, it's a gold edition $2 bill note.
Oh.
So, this is special edition. You're special to me. To my ceremony team, Uncle Russell gave a wonderful invocation. Kimberly, darling, thank you for all your support. Deborica, my girl from back from Memorial. The Elijah and his catering team, Mr. Gordon. The photographer team and the DJ, Michael, I appreciate your help. Thank you for all your support. The ceremony is a success because of you. Our 35th president of the United States, President John F. Kennedy, lived a brief 46 years, but a defining quote he made I would like to share. Efforts and courage are not enough without purpose and direction. Hidden within the Finance Corps' motto has been my military purpose and direction. The motto is to support and serve. I've always gave my best effort in any position and assignment that I was in. To serve with and for the sons and daughters of the American people is an overwhelming duty. And I continue to provide the best leadership and service to support our soldiers and their families. And in return, the leaders of the United States Army have selected me for the promotion to the rank of Lieutenant Colonel. But I want you to know that this is not an achievement I have gained alone. I stand on the shoulders of many outstanding people in my life. Soldiers, non-commissioned officers, commissioned officers, warrant officers, Department of the Army civilians that I have worked and served with side by side through my career, and my family and friends here today. It's because of everyone's instruction, love, hard work, fond memories, welcoming open arms, professionalism, support of family, thoughtful gestures, and care for my family and I that I've made it this far. Last and most importantly, all of this is just a blessing. I'm blessed and grateful for the favor that God has upon my life. Thank you for coming today. God bless you. God bless America. Army strong.
Freedom is not free.
Here's another favorite. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the playing of the Army song. This concludes today's ceremony. Thank you for attending. Lieutenant Colonel Taylor and his family will be available up front for you to offer your congratulations. Also, the family would like to invite you to join them for a complimentary dinner by Mr. Elijah Davis of Happy Tummy Catering. Thank you.